Campinas, and I am a PhD student at DERI, the Digital Enterprise Research Institute. And I represent today our work about the MF ranking model, which is a model about that consists in ranking entities in the web of data. And this work has been funded by the LOT2 European project. So we all know this picture. So it's a LOD cloud, a huge collection of interlinked data sets. And it is spread among a lot of domains, life science, statistics, geodata, and so on and so forth. But in this work, we do not only want to consider the LOD cloud, but also all the semi-structured data that is found on the web. So for example, in e-commerce websites, such as Best Buy, or in social networks, Facebook, Twitter. And in the Synice project, what we want to do is to index all of this data that you can find on the web, so only the semi-structured data that you can find on the web. And at the moment, we have accumulated a huge amount of data. So 50 billion of trippers and counting is for now indexed by Synice, and consists of approximately like 3 billion of entities and spread among 100K data sets. And so when you have all of this data, at some point you want to look for some piece of information inside that is relevant for your information need. And this is a huge challenge, because how do you find the entities that are relevant for what you want to search for? As there is a lot of challenge in terms of data quality. For example, we are taking a lot of data from user-defined data. And so there is a problem of spam of user-defined data. There is the ontology that changed from one entity to the other. And also the way to describe this data changed from one entity to the other. So there's a lot of variability here. So here is an example of an entity in Synice. It's the entity Galway, and it has different properties, such as where it is located in or what it is famous for. And there exist different ranking approaches for ranking this kind of entities. So you have static ranking, that is, for example, a page rank. But we have also query time ranking. So the relevance of the entity is calculated when the query is being processed. And this is the query time ranking is what we want to study in this paper. There exist many entity ranking approaches, but we'll consider here only two of them. So the PRF, which is the probability relevance framework, it bases the ranking on the relevance probability of a document with regard to a query. And we have also the DFR framework, which is DFR for divergence from randomness. The difference with the previous one is that it estimates how much the document term distribution in the document differ from a random distribution. If it differ a lot, well, we will say it's relevant. In this talk, I will talk about mainly the PRF ranking models, so all the BM25-based ones. And we see that this model can be applied on different level of the document, of the entity. So on the document level, on the attribute level, and on the value level, which is the one that we proposed. So if we have our entity graph, I need to modelize it in order to be able to rank it. Here, we just said that the entity is a document, and everything that you had about this entity, you put it inside this document, and it's like a huge bag of words because there is no special relation between them. So it's just simple like that. And some examples of this document model ranking are BM25 and PL2. However, in the LDF data entities, you have some structure. And here, there has been some approaches to add this structure into the ranking model. So here, it's a simple one. You just say that your document has, in fact, is in fact composed of attributes or fields. So here we extracted from the previous document that it had a body where I just put all of the data inside. And I extracted the entity name as another attribute of this document. So here we have two attributes, the body and the title. Such examples are BM25F and PL2F. Again, we say that the content of an attribute is not actually one big bag of words, but it is actually a set of values because you can have multiple values for one attribute. So, and therefore, in this model, each value is a bag of words. The examples of these models are BM25MF and PL2MF, the ones that we proposed in the paper. So I will explain now in little more detail how the ranking is done on the document level. So here we have two entities. On the right, we have the Galway Bay FM entity with some properties such as the body. Galway Bay FM is a local radio, and the title. On the left, we have the entity Galway. So it's a city in the county of Galway. So in this document model, all the data about an entity is considered as a document. And for example, if I have the query Galway Island, I will compute the number of occurrences of this query in the entity here on the left, which is three for the terms of Galway and one for the term Ireland. On the right, the term Galway will have 10 occurrences plus one, which is in the title. And Ireland also has one occurrence of the term island. Because the entity Galway Bay FM has more occurrences of the term Galway, it will be ranked higher than the other one. And this is not actually what you want. We want to have the entity Galway city as the first result. So now we add one more level, which is the attribute level. So we have still the same entity as before. However, now each of the attributes of the entity are considered as bag of words. So now the document is not a simple bag of words, but a set of attributes, each being a bag of words. So again, with the same query. And now, just as before, the attribute body in the Galway Bay FM entity is more important than the attribute body in the Galway City entity because it has more occurrences of the term Galway. And as a consequence, the whole entity Galway Bay FM is ranked higher. In the MF model, we add the one more level, which is the value. And we said that each value is now a bag of words in itself. And what we can say with the same query here, Galway Island, we can say that we can apply some kind of operation, which is here a normalization operation. So for example, the attribute body has 10 values associated to it. And let's imagine that in the whole collection, the entities that have the attribute body have, on average, only one value. So we can say that the Galway BFM has some kind of spam, or it has too many values, so we can push it down using this normalization operation. So therefore, this time, the attribute body in Galway BFM is ranked as a lower importance than the Galway City one. As a consequence, the whole entity, Galway, is ranked higher than the Galway BFM entity. Using the MF model ranking, we can apply different weight on each level of your model. So on the entity level, on the attribute level, or deeper on the value level. In the paper, we have introduced two kinds of weights. The first one that we present here is the query coverage, which idea is to lower the importance of a level the less query terms it has. So for example, with the same query Galway Island, I have two query terms. However, in the entity on the left, I have two terms occurring in the value. And on the entity on the right, I have only one term occurring in each value. As a consequence, the entity B is ranked lower than the entity A. I present now the second weight, using the same entities as in the previous example. So here we have the entity A, which has a label Stéphane Campinas, and the entity B, which has the label Stéphane Moreno lives in Campinas City. And the idea of this weight is to increase the importance of a value, the more a query covers this value. So as an example, on the entity A, I have only two terms in my value, and in the entity B, there are six terms. However, I have only two query terms occurring in these values. As a consequence, the value Stéphane Campinas will be more important than the value in the entity B. So now I will just enter and present in a little more detail the ranking approaches. So here we have the scoring mechanism, which consists of computing the relevance of a Word document with regard to a query by summing all the relevance of each terms in the document. The relevance of a term consists of a static weight value, which is here the IDF for inverse document frequency. This value gives just the importance of the term in the word collection. So the idea is that if a term appears a lot in the collection, it is less important than a term occurring less. The TFN term in the equation is the relevance of the term in the document itself, not in the collection. So here we have the BM25, and it computes the relevance of the term TFN, taking the number of occurrences in the document of the term. And here we can see that we apply a normalization, which helps in taking care of the different document lengths in the collection. So here we normalize the relevance of this term to the average document length. For the attribute, in the attribute level, we have the BM25F, and what it does is, okay, like before, we apply the same function on the frequency of the term. However, this time, this frequency of the term in the document is spread among all the attributes. So therefore, we have this sum. Like before, we apply also a normalization, this time not to the document length, but to the average of the attribute length. In the BM25MF ranking model, so like before, we start from the top, and we say that actually the frequency of the term is spread among all the attributes, and the frequency of each term in the attribute is composed of multiple values. So here we have these two sums to reflect the fact that we have the value, the attribute level and the value level. Like before, we apply also a normalization operation on the term relevance. So here it's not. So here it is to the average value length in the collection. But what is important with this MF ranking model, it is that it adds another normalization operation, which is to the number of values in this attribute. We can see that using these formulas, we can apply different weight mechanism on each level. So in red on top, we can apply a weight on the document level. In blue, we can apply weights on the attributes level. And in green, at the bottom, we can apply a weight on the value level. And so we can see that with the MF ranking model, you have much more possibility to tune the model, to tune it to the actual entities. So just to wrap up a bit, so we have presented in this paper the MF ranking model. MF is for multi-valued attribute, and it is a generalization of existing attributed approaches. And this model is nice because it adds two layers in the entity model, one on the attribute, one on the value, and you can add some weights and some normalization operation, which is great for semi-structured data when you have many variability in the entity. And it seemed that this model worked quite well, as we proposed it last year in the Yahoo Challenge, and we finished first place in the entity track. Now I'll speak a bit about the evaluation that we performed on this ranking model. So we used two data sets. One, the billion triple challenge, which consists of 1 billion triples, approximately. And the other one is on Deepedia. The billion triple challenge has two query sets over it, the same search 2010 and 2001 challenges. And we used the INEX 2009 query topics on the Deepedia dataset. So we performed three kinds of evaluation. In this first one, we experiment with the normalization operation to show that it has a great impact on the ranking. So for in this experiment that I will show here, I will show you only the ones on INEX and the one on SS 2010, just for visibility issue concern. So you have on the x-axis the normalization parameter on the attribute that varies. It varies from 0 to 1. 0, there is no normalization. 1, there is completely. For the BM35F, we can see that when we vary this parameter up there in blue from 0 to 1, the ranking performance varies a lot. And so already it has a great impact on the performance. With the BM35MF, we performed the same experiment. And we have also, on the x-axis, the attribute normalization parameter. And we drew one curve for each value of the value normalization parameter in green. And so what is important here to see is that these normalization parameters that we introduced in the MF ranking model allows a finer tuning of your entities, finer tuning of the ranking mechanism. In this second evaluation, we have as a baseline the BM35MF approach, and we compare to it several baselines, such as TF-IDF, BM25, and BM25F on the three data sets. The difference is computed in terms of percentage, and we can see that the BM25MF allows a better ranking performance than the other ones. You can see that on the left you have negative values, so negative percentage in terms of difference. So here it was the same to evaluate the different weights that we introduced in the paper, and we showed that they allow an even better ranking performance. So to conclude, we have introduced the MF ranking model, which is a generalization of existing attribute-based models. And we have seen that the two layers of this model, so the attribute and the value, allow a finer tuning of the ranking. And you can also have weights to have a better ranking again. And we have seen that this model incurs a significant performance increase. And the future work consists in extending this model to rank more complex trees than what we have, than what we presented here. Sorry. So more than two levels, trees with more than two levels, and we want to find the ways to dynamic to tune at the query time the normalization parameter, because we saw in those graph that it has a great impact on the performance and it changed from one data set to the other. So it's better if it is done dynamically. Well, that's it. Thank you.
About the normalization parameters. If I understand well, they are very dependent.